gracias. Muchas gracias.
De nada, nuestro primer ponente de Francia. ¿Cómo va Francia en la Eurocopa?
Muy bien.
¿Cuándo juega? ¿Hoy o jugó ayer?
Después. No, sí, ahora yo.
Hoy juega.
Sí.
Bueno, pero, éxitos. Salga sí. bien.
Muchas
Viva
gracias.
España.
Buen día a todos. Me disculpo por mi nivel español. El único cosa que conoces es un poema de Federico García Lorca. La señorita del abanico va por el puente del Frescorillo. Muchas gracias. Okay, I will do it in English. I'm the executive director and partner of a company called Pixmania.com. I have 20 minutes. It's a big presentation, so I will go very fast because there's a lot of information. So let's start right away. First of all, let's talk about Pixmania.com and what is the group today. We operate in 26 countries. We started the business 12 years ago, so we're getting old. We do one-third of our turnover in France, two-thirds outside, so we are completely European. We actually started in Spain back in July 2002, and Spain is our number three country, so it's very strategic for us. Our pride is that we started the company, we were six of us, and now we employ 1,400 people. We have about 10 million customers across Europe, and 30 million people, unique visitors, coming to our website every month. We also operate stores, and that I will come to it afterwards, across Europe. We have 20 stores in Europe. Back in 2006, we sold 77% of our business to the Dixons Group. Dixons is the number two distributor of consumer electronic products and home appliances in Europe and the number three in the world. They operate about 1,300 shops, they employ 40,000 people, and they do about 8.3 billion sterling turnover. So we still own 23% of the business, but they own 77%. Two main activities and six brands for the Pixmania Group. Pixmania.com, which you might know, B2C for people like you and I. Pixmania Pro, our B2B business. Webhallen is the only company that we acquired within the group. It's a Swedish company. They do about 82 million euro just in Sweden, so it's a very big company in Sweden. I'll show it to you afterwards. MyPix.com is the online photo printing website. Our marketplace. We started the marketplace on Pixmania, so we host third-party merchants on the Pixmania website, and we take a commission on the sale. So I encourage you, obviously, to list your products if you have a store on the marketplace. Pixmania Pro, our B2B business, which is about 20% of the total business of Pixmania now, is a very good business. And eMerchant is basically everything we've done over the past 12 years. Now, it's a platform, an e-commerce platform, where we help other companies to run their e-commerce across Europe. So for instance, we run the e-commerce of Carrefour, we run the e-commerce of Dixon's, Currys, more than 2.5 billion of euros of transactions were made on the platform last year. So the reason behind the success, if we can call it a success, we still have a lot of work to do, it's Europe. We started in France back in 2001, but right in January 2002, we opened Germany, then we opened Spain, Italy, Portugal, and now we're in 26 countries. So every year, we opened up. So we grew with the euro. And also the diversification of the product range. So here is our homepage back in 2005, only electronics. I think that if we were trading only on electronics today, maybe I wouldn't be here. Electronics is very tough. Here, this is what it looks today. 30 different categories of products, baby products, toys, jewelry. We've opened up 3 to 4 categories for the past 5 years, every year. This is a small clip about this right now. We'll be right back. So e-commerce is simple. It's a tough environment, and I'll tell you about the future, the vision of how we see e-commerce in the next years. Clearly, customers is at the heart of the strategy. You have to always focus on the fundamentals of e-commerce. Getting the best product at the best price, always in stock. It seems simple, but it is the hardest thing that you can do online. Everything is about improving customer experience. We think today that customers, they buy social. They need an experience. They live to live their passion. If you only compete on the pricing, on the price, you're dead. E-commerce and retail. Before, this is what we had. Move to web. And today, this is what it looks like. The war between brick and mortar is online is over. Now, a company, a retail company, cannot afford not to be open 365 days a year, 24 hours. So the online retailers are opening stores. We decided to open stores. We have 5 stores in Spain today. We are actually opening 2 new stores in the summer. We'll have 7 stores by the end of September. And almost all brands have their e-commerce websites. So what has changed? Users are a lot more equipped and mature. They are more experienced, more intransigent, they know what they want, they compare on internet, they buy, they share, and vice versa. And the sales channel is extremely important. Someone wants to buy whenever he wants, whatever they want, all the time. And it is very demanding. Smartphones and tablets have really changed the way we work. So here it is, a bit of a focus in Europe, some European numbers. 74% of households in Europe are equipped with a PC. 104 million of smartphone users in the top 5 countries in Europe. 141 million of mobile buyers in Europe in 2011. And you have 106 million Europeans that will have a tablet in 2016. Here, when you think about Europe, think that it's very different. Europe is a beautiful word, but it doesn't exist. You need to adapt to every country. So here it is. We can be very proud because we are the number one e-commerce market today. I'm saying that because in 3 years, China will be number one, for sure. China is growing by 66%. They're at 97 billion euro market e-commerce. UK is 84 billion euro. Compared to Spain, 10.5 billion. In Spain, about 55% of the population is connected. And only 43% of the internet users are actually shoppers. Where in most mature countries, it's at least 70% of the shoppers, of the internet shoppers, of the internet, internet users are shoppers. So there's a huge diversity between the different countries. The question of implementing stores. Why are we going online? Why now we're going offline? Because truth is that before, 5 years ago, when we were a pure player, only selling online, we were the only one. I mean, only with pure players. And then brands came. And then traditional retailers came online. And for everything that is electronics or white goods, I would say the most mature market, 15% of the business is done online. So what do you do? You still compete in a market where it's only 15% of the retail, and you have 100 more competitors than 5 years ago because everybody's going online, or do you open stores? We think that the best combination is stores and e-commerce. So, high street retailers are cannibalizing e-commerce? It's the other way around. When we started the business, everybody was telling us, you're killing retail. And actually now, is it the other way around? It's a joke, of course. So the development of e-commerce of stores is extremely important. What does it mean for retailer strategy? Develop cross-canal. Forget about multi-canal. Now, the true word is cross-canal. It's not only one store online and the traditional store. It's how do you make them connect? Only cross-canal. So complementarity between sales channels to generate additional revenues. retain, engage customers, play with the customer across the channel. This is our stores, our new formatted stores. Looks good, huh? So buy online, click and collect, reserve and collect, product returns in stores, loyalty cards. So this is a bit of an example of what we do with a click and collect. Obviously, you can choose the store that you want. Okay, this is one of the e-commerce sites that we power under our platform. And for Pixmania, this is what we've done. In our store, which is about 150 meters square, you have 1,200 products. You also have computers where you have access to 1.4 million products. So it's the complementarity of the two words. But you have internet prices all the time. You have here electronic prices. Every time that we change a price on the website, on Pixmania, it changes the price automatically in the store. This is the agility of the web. Best combination of both worlds. The customer is always sure to have the best price. Because the store next to us, it takes a lot more time for him to change his prices. Mobile strategy. I'm going to show you a clip of how mobile changed the business.
South Korea is a unique market.
In South Korea.
Tesco has been evolving itself, adjusting to the local market. It even changed the name itself from Tesco to Home Plus. And at last, it grew to rank number 2 in Korea. But Tesco had to overcome one obstacle, a fewer number of stores compared to the number 1 company, E-Mart. Mission: could we become number 1 without increasing the number of stores? We made an in-depth study into Koreans once more. Koreans are the second most hardworking people in the world. For them, grocery shopping once a week is a dreaded task. So we decided to approach these busy and tired people. Idea: let the store come to the people. We created virtual stores, hoping to blend into people's everyday lives. Our first try was subway stations. Although virtual, the displays were exactly the same as actual stores, from the display to the merchandise. Only one thing was different. You use smartphones to shop. Scan the QR code with your phone and the product automatically lands in your online cart. When the online purchase is done, it will be delivered to your door right after you get home. People can relax more after work and on weekends.
실제로 보면서 사니까 진짜 더 좋은 것 같아요. 편하기도 하고.
Result: people can shop at Tesco Home Plus wherever they go without having to visit the actual store. Moreover, we could change their waiting time to shopping time. After this campaign, online sales increased tremendously. Through this campaign, 10,287 consumers visited the online Home Plus mall using smartphones. The number of new registered members rose by 76%, and online sales increased 130%. Currently, Home Plus has become number 1 in the online market and is a very close second offline.
So that's future. I'm here talking about to you about the future of retail, of how we see the future in terms of retail. Everything will be in your mobile phone, for sure. This is what we do in Webhallen, our Swedish company. You go on a product page, and you can choose to buy by mobile. We have an application called Payair. We work with them. And directly on the product page, you have the QR code that appears. With your phone, you've downloaded already the application on BlackBerry or iPhone, you just scan the QR code. No need to go check out. So you're a lot faster in your ordering process, and directly the product is shipped to your home. No need to get your credit cards. Everything is on your phone, protected by a PIN code. Improve the customer experience. The amazing thing about e-commerce is basically it's non-biased. When you are in a shop, obviously, sometimes the products are not well ranged. Here, you can do everything that you want. This is Nintendo, for instance, a shopping shop. Use that experience. Create your site so that people can leave social and really can leave the experience of the brand. This is how you will differentiate yourself. This is, for instance, what we do for Skull Candy. This is hundreds of pages just for one brand.
To keep us quiet.
The rules. Let's make some noise.
Okay, and this is what we call a shopping shop, exactly like in a store, but within Pixmania. Two things that we like very much. In Zara, what Zara did is the people experience. They say to their fans, take picture of your clothes, and the best picture will be put online. And the best picture, you will earn 300 euros. What VANCL did, one of the biggest textile company in China, they allow users to create into their website their own web shop with the VANCL clause. So they take pictures of themselves, and every sales that are generated through their own shop within VANCL, the customer gets 10% commission. Truth is that the best ambassador is the customer. Customers are the ambassador of the brand all the time. And this is social shopping. We've created the Pix Expert. You know, when you go into a shop, you never find Rob. And Rob is the person, let's say for your TV, who will give you five top questions of why do you need a TV? Where do you need it? What size of a TV do you need? And depending on what your answer is, he's going to propose a different range of TVs. And then you can play with the budget. Rob is always in good shape. Never commissioned by a brand. He can serve 10,000 people at the same time. And that's also the future of e-commerce. It's basically helping the customer all the time. But you need to generate exclusive content. I'm going to show you a clip of our company in Sweden, Webhallen, what they do when they launch new video games in their store, because they also operate stores. Here it is. This is passion. Okay, you need to engage the customer. Every release of a video game that they do, they have thousands of people waiting in line. All the news are here, all the time. People sleep the day before in front of the store. We also do a lot of social shopping like Gift Mania, where on Facebook we always try to find implementation, application, where we're going to make it one day or another possible to increase the number of turnover that we'll get of business through Facebook. So here, it's an application that we've done on Facebook where, depending on your friends, you download the application, and regarding all the interest of your friends, the product catalog of Pixmania will be linked to the interest of your friends. And directly, you can shop for your friends. Here, this is a very good thing, whiskeyblender.com. Users on their website can create their own whiskey. Converse, for instance, have made an application where you can create your own Converse and sell it on the Converse website. The rise of WeCommerce, how we get social. This is something that we've done, a group gift, where you get people to participate within Facebook to organize gifts, group gifts. I'll show you something else, extremely important. This is also live chat. Customers, it's your customers who are doing customers experience, customer service to your customers. So it's your customers talking to your customers on your website live. And I'm just finishing by one thing. It's all the social media, Facebook, Twitter, Google+, Pinterest. You have to be on Pinterest, one of the latest social network, Tumblr. And you need to expand across Europe very fast also. But you need to do it in a very, very customized way. Here, just to show you the complexity of our payment methods. We use 40 payment methods across Europe, 11 currencies across Europe, and this is part of our partners. 27 carriers across Europe. Same thing, the carrier is the ambassador of your brand. Choose the right carrier. And the combined expertise, and this is the last slide, it's basically everything we've done for all the past years. Now, what we think is that it's very tough to earn money online. Extremely tough to earn money when you are a middle to big size e-commerce site. And where you can get the money is really by adding the service. So the margin get really through the service, through the marketplace. And also by using a platform. So we sell now the platform, and this is really by using the service and all the expertise that we've done over the past 12 years online in Europe, where we help other companies to do it. But e-commerce is a very challenging world. So here it is. This is some of our clients across Europe for our platform. And every time we adapt to the brand of the client. So this is powered by eMerchant, the subsidiary of Pixmania. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Allí arriba, por favor. Gracias.
Great presentation. I like it.
Thank you.
Welcome. Okay. Okay, era una pregunta falsa. ¿Alguna pregunta? E-commerce es el momento. Ahí hay una. Ahí. Venga, gracias.
¿Qué tal? I'd like to ask about your virtual seller. What's the conversion rate? I mean, when you use your virtual assistant?
Conversion rate on what? On the website, on our website?
Yeah, on the website. Or it's a different type of sell. I mean, you receive a couple of questions, and
For the Pix Expert.
Yeah.
Okay.
Pix Expert, yeah.
The conversion rate on the category where we have the Pix Expert, and when the people are using Pix Expert, so Rob, is 4 times higher than our average conversion rate. It makes sense. It's completely customer-centric. It takes a lot of development, but it's for the customer and 4 times higher.
Well, congratulations.
Una pregunta aquí adelante, la última. Ahí te llega el micrófono.
Ulrich, congratulations.
Thank you.
Regarding Rob, the virtual assistant, is it a knowledge base? Is it like you type a question like IKEA? You go to IKEA and you say, you know, how do I do this? And they just answer you with a pre-formatted question, it's another computer, or it's somebody chatting behind?
No. The way it works is that, okay, we have Rob, we have Noemi, you know, we have, depending on the category of products.
Sure.
So Noemi will help you, for instance, with the baby products and stuff like this. And the way it works is that we go around all the suppliers, all the people that know very well, you know, the products, and also the customers, we do a survey. And with that survey, we take like 5 questions, the best questions that any one of the best salesperson in a shop should ask you when you come into the shop. So it's 5 pre-written questions that you have to answer. So it's not someone behind; it's already decided.
It's like knowledge base.
Exactly, it's knowledge base based on the expertise of experts.
Okay, well, are you going to be around today?
Yeah, no, I'm.
I'm going to have lunch with us.
Thank you. Pablo, thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for everything.
Gracias.
Thank you.